Hidden inside was the Wanderer's journal. Our feet are weary, the hours long. There will be much to do when we arrive. I tell my companion of those waiting at home. They do not seem to know what to say. The pig had vanished, but something moved beneath the surface. In a muddy pond, Ember thought the pig looked a lot less imposing. The pig shouted joyously. The water feels so good on the skin. Join me, morsel. The pig seemed happy, but Ember wasn't getting too close. Why do I consume whatever people put in front of me? I need some true nourishment, but there's none left here. But so much cooler in this muddy pond, I can finally think. Thank you, morsel. Ember thought about the pig. Fed to bursting by others but without nourishment. Who had the pig been before? Ember wondered. Cheerily, the stranger said, "Don't say much, little friend, do you? Remind me of one of those golem statues. Stood there, mouth open. I like you." Inside was a secret diary entry. The satchel is almost bare, our supplies exhausted. The taste of a good meal is not easily forgotten, but it slipped my mind to thank the cook. Thank you. stone golem frozen in the lake, a relic from a forgotten time. Ember watched as the helpful piggy cleared the path. A lost message was inside. Our music crafts our path, bridging over any we pass. My companion's hand clutches mine. We dart like fireflies through the swamp. The stranger stretched their limbs. Perhaps it is not too late after all. Ember found a secret note from the Wanderer. A memory laps at the edge of my dreams. A time before the water, someone I wished to stay for. We must hurry home. The pot had turned cold. The fire had died. Nothing the cook made felt good enough. Endlessly stirring the same tasteless pot. Couldn't focus, sleepwalking through the days. Aimed inwards was a swirl of thoughts. In the eye of the storm, a fragile flicker. They wanted to serve something perfect. The praise of others was hollow. The cook felt numb and hurt all at once. Spoke softly. Oh, hello, little one. I didn't see you. I must have lost myself for a moment. It's supposed to be my new soup recipe. But it's not ready. It's not done. A wonderful smell wafted towards Ember. You look starving, poor thing. Have a little taste, but it's not right yet. It was the most beautiful thing Ember had ever tasted. I know. It's got no flavor, nothing special. Ember wished the cook would believe them. Oh, I used to love this. Just want to be good at it. But it feels like I'm making the same things over and over. Nothing has flavor. I'm stuck. Oh, I'd forgotten how good it feels feeding folk. But it's not ready. There's no need to pretend just to make me feel better. The cook stirred their soup, looking at Ember, looking at the pot, stirring, thinking. Soon, maybe. If you know what you want, I can try. But I really need some better ingredients. Something from the orchard could have worked. If it was still standing. Oh. The cook struggled to hold back their emotions. Pigs have gotten in me orchard. Planted every sapling I did. All me hard work ruined. Take the key and have a look yourself. I can't bear to. See if anything is left, but I promise you, there won't be.